Welcome back to Midday. We are starting the show off with Mayor Ken Christian, who's joining us on the show. Thanks for being here, Ken.
Always a pleasure.
This is the first time we've sat down with you since re-election. So first of all, congratulations to you. And I know that you've got a lot of new faces on council this year, or this time around. It's a new era in civic politics, if you will.
Yeah, you know, we had our inaugural meeting on Monday night, and there was an air of excitement around it. There was, you know, some change up. You know, four out of the nine of us are new, and so that's going to bring some fresh ideas, some renewal, some, you know, new energy to the council chambers. And, you know, we've been just steeped in an orientation process this week and for the next 3 weeks, actually. And so it's exciting to get to know new people and to listen to their ideas and see how that's going to manifest itself in terms of the strategic plan of this new council. So exciting times in Kamloops.
I can't imagine that it would be, you know, terribly easy to learn the ropes of you know, sitting around the council table and how sort of that process works and you know, different things that have to go, you know, the application process for rent, you know, things and you know, they've got to learn all of these things. Is that going to be a tough thing for them, for four new people all at once to learn that? Like, would that be the most people that we've ever seen at one time having to learn the new ropes?
It's certainly the biggest changeover that we've seen in some time in the city of Kamloops. But, you know, these are bright people. They didn't get elected by accident. And so, you know, they all are quite studious and quite, you know, on task in terms of the orientation thus far. So there's the legal aspects, there's the statutory stuff, there's all of the finances, and then there's all of the IT and communications and that sort of stuff. So it's daunting, but I've just seen a certain amount of excitement, you know, on them. And I've also heard and listened to some great questions that they're asking. So, you know, I think that we're well positioned going forward. So we'll spend this next 3 to 4 weeks touring, visiting departments, understanding the mechanics and workings of the city, and then take a little break over Christmas, and then we'll sit down and we'll hammer out a strategic plan. So that will really be the document that we are going to subscribe to for the next 4 years going forward. So, and I suspect that document will reflect a piece of everyone that's around that horseshoe and their ideas and their visions for the future of Kamloops.
Switching gears just a little bit here, Ken, I know that we're a few weeks in now to legalization of cannabis, and Kamloops having the one and only store you know, drew a lot of attention. What are your thoughts on Kamloops? We've heard the term cannabis hub. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, and I've heard that the Twitter handle Campsterdam is actually trending.
So, yes, it is.
But, you know, this is just a point in time anomaly, quite frankly, that other municipalities in British Columbia will catch up. We happen to be open for business and ready with the kinds of tools that you need to be able to license these stores. So we have the first, and now, you know, our staff have reported back that the lineups have finally subsided. But it's obvious that there's a demand for recreational marijuana that's legalized, and that demand is bigger than one store can handle, because, you know, they're selling out, and there's some supply issues right now. But last meeting, we introduced two new private sector stores into the mix, and I believe at the meeting at the end of the month, we have an application for at least one and perhaps two other government stores. So they're going to really dot the retail landscape around the city, and I suspect this time next year it'll just be like most other kinds of retail operations. Some will succeed, some will fail, and they'll be innovative in terms of their craft product or their, you know, different kinds of marketing that they're going to be using. We have a good neighbor agreement with each of them that really dictates how they are going to run those businesses. There's no access to minors, there's no loitering around them, there's no smoking of cannabis out in front. So, you know, that's important for neighbors, but I think it does reflect the fact that the government of Canada have decided that in this country, recreational marijuana will be legal.
All right. Thanks, Ken. That we're out of time. I know you will be at the Remembrance Day ceremony on Sunday. And, of course, you're all decked out for the Military Appreciation Night tonight at the Blazers game. So thank you for joining us. And we will talk about the Military Appreciation Night, which is tonight, coming up right after a break. Stay with us.